Welcome to the Fit Small Business Xero Training Course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to create an income statement, also known as a profit and loss statement in Xero. To follow along with me, log into your Xero account now or click the link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. You can also click this link to access our full Xero course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. Income statements show you the revenue, expenses, and net profit or loss of your business for a period of time. This report helps you understand your profitability, including insight into what areas of your business are generating revenue and where you are spending your money. Based on the results of this report, you can determine the following: areas of your business where you need to generate more sales, expenses that can be reduced or eliminated altogether, and trends in profitability, for example, certain times during the year where you are more profitable than others. Your income statement will only be as accurate as the information that you have entered into Xero. Therefore, you must stay on top of entering all invoices, bills, credit notes, and banking transactions into Xero. Click the links below to access each of these lessons. By staying on top of entering day-to-day business transactions, you will have accurate and reliable income statements that you can review at least on a monthly basis. Reviewing your income statement on a monthly basis has the following advantages. You'll be able to identify revenue or expenses that have been categorized to the wrong account. You'll be able to catch missing income and expenses which could over or understate what is reported on your tax return. And you'll be able to take proactive steps to increase your profit. To create an income statement in Xero from the Xero dashboard, you want to go ahead and click on Reports and then select All Reports. The income statement report is going to be located in the Financial section here. Please note that there are actually two income statements listed here. Xero has redesigned several reports, and the income statement is one of those reports. For the purposes of this lesson, we will discuss the new income statement report, which is indicated with the new button here to the right. Please also note that you can actually add a report to your favorites by clicking on the star to the left of the name of the report. So if we click on the star to the left here of income statement, and we go back up to our reports menu, instead of going to all reports, we can easily access our report right here on the menu tab here. So that's just a quick way to get to your reports when you need to. So let's go ahead and launch that new income statement report. And in this screen, we can select our time period that we'd like to run the report for. So in the date range field here, we can select a preset date range from the dropdown, or you can actually select custom and then select your date range that you'd like to use here in this section. Once you've made your date selection, go ahead and click the update button to refresh the report. So here is our sample income statement for our fictitious company, Acme Web Pros Plus. The income statement can be exported to a PDF, Excel, or Google Sheets. Just scroll down to the bottom of the report, click the export button, and make your selection from there. You can also save the report as a draft, published, or custom report. The draft option allows you to create a report that you or someone else can make changes to later on. You might create several draft reports before you are ready to publish them. The published option is used to save reports when you are finalizing the books for the month or the year. A published report will not change if for some reason the information in the system has changed or updated in some way. You can only publish reports if you have the advisor user role. You can click this link to learn more about user roles. The custom option is used to save a report format so that you don't have to recreate it each time you run the report. Xero will ask you if you would like to make the custom template as your default. And if you'd like to do that, then you'll be able to save that report as your default going forward. We'll show you how to save a custom report format in the next section. You can easily modify report settings in Xero in one of three ways. You can change the report title, you can change the report settings, and you can change the layout and format of the report. So changing a report title. You can change the title of most reports in Xero. To do this, just hover your mouse right over the report title as I'm doing here, and to the far right, you'll see a link that says Edit Title. If you click that link, you can actually make the change to the report easily here. So we will change the name of this report from Income Statement to Profit and Loss Statement. Each report in Xero allows you to also change a few report settings. And so to do that, you can click the report settings link for each report. It will be located in the same place, directly to the right of the date range field. So if we click on that, for the income statement, we are able to actually change the comparison, how many periods we want to compare the report to, the accounting basis, the numbers, and also the region or tracking categories. So let's talk about each of these. The comparison here allows you to select previous periods that you would like to compare the current period that you're running to. So for example, our current period that we're running this report for is for the financial year January 1 to December 31st, 2017. So if we selected the previous period of 1, then we would have a column comparing this year's report to last year, 2016. And so we'll show you how that works in a second. Accounting basis. In general, most businesses use the cash method of accounting. However, the beauty of using Xero is that you can run your reports using either accounting method. Just make your selection here. So the default for all reports will be accrual, but you can easily switch it over to the cash method. Numbers. If you prefer not to have decimals show on your report, you can remove this check mark here that says show decimals. And then finally, region. If you have set up tracking categories in Xero, then you can filter this report that will show all tracking categories you have set up, or you can remove the all option and just select individual tracking categories that you would like to track. And last but not least, don't forget to click the update button so that all of your changes will be made on the report. And so here is our report based on the changes that we have made. As you can see, we've got a column now here for that previous year, 2016. The Edit Layout Designer tool allows you to further customize the look of your report. Some of the customizations you can do with this tool are add additional columns for tracking notes or totals, change account groupings, edit formulas, rearrange columns by clicking and dragging. To show you how this works, let's dive in and create a report for our fictitious company, Acme Web Pros Plus. Acme would like to create a custom income statement that will show the previous month so that they can spot trends and possible red flags. Acme would like to save the report as a custom report and make it their default report. This will allow them to quickly run the report without having to recreate it each time. So let's create the custom income statement for the month of June for Acme Web Pros Plus. So we'll go back up to the top and we will select a date range here. So we want to run this for the month of June. And so we've got that set up. We'll click the update button. And then let's go ahead and take a peek at our report settings. So for the comparison, this report is going to be run for the month of June. However, Acme would like to be able to see a side-by-side comparison of each month going all the way back to the beginning of the year, January. So by selecting a 5 here, the report will show us not only the month of June, but it will go all the way back to January and show the comparison for each month. And we'll go ahead and switch the accounting basis to cash. And then let's go ahead and update the report. And so as you can see, here's our updated report. We've got our current month that we wanted to run the report for June here. And then next to it, we've got each of the 5 months that we'd like to compare it to going back to January. So while this report does look great, if you are concerned about each month individually, we should also be able to see what the total income, expenses, and net income are for all 6 months combined. Now, this is where the Edit Layout Designer tool comes in handy. So at the very bottom of the report, you want to click on the Edit Layout button here. And here is our Edit Layout Designer. So at the very top, this section is the Edit Layout Designer toolbar. So in this section, we have the ability to customize our text. We have the ability to create a schedule within the report. We can add a footer to the report. We can add a row, or we can add a column. So we're going to go ahead for this example and add a column to the report. Now, as we make changes to the report, we'll be able to see the impact of those changes in real time in this section of the template here. And then over to the right, you'll see how that works when we get ready to create our formula for our total column. So to go ahead and add a column, we'll click the columns icon here. And this particular column, since it is going to be a total, we need to create a formula. So we'll go ahead and select formula. And now that opens up this section where we need to actually create our formula. So first of all, we'll click the insert button. And so here we want to let Xero know which columns need to be totaled up for our new column. So we'll start with the January column. And since we want a total, we'll click the plus sign. And then we'll go back and basically you want to select each column that needs to be included in the formula that you are creating. And then below that, we've got a field that says name. So this is just basically what do we want the title of that column to be. And so we'll just simply call it total. And once you are satisfied with your changes, you can click this blue button that says done. Here is our updated income statement report for Acme with our new total column. So now as you can see, we've got total income that we can see now. And we've also got total expenses here and our net loss here totaled up for all 6 months. So that wraps up the lesson on how to create an income statement in Xero. To access our full Xero course or any of the other lessons in this series, click this link. You can also find a link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. If you have feedback about this course or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.